Dear students, Jai Hind, very good morning. Welcome back to our e-learning session. As you all know that we are continuing a new chapter, chapter number 6, Ratio and Proportion. You have already attended lecture number 1 in that. And you have got the concept, understand, you have got idea about direct variation, understood. What is in our lecture number 1, I have already mentioned you and I have already explained the meaning of variation, and we also understood the meaning of direct variation, that we understood, okay. Now actually what we are targeting in today's lecture number 2, we are targeting to solve some of the examples, understand, no doubt from your textbook exercise, and some of the problems we will discuss, understand, by I will just narrate some of the examples and we will try to solve it, okay. So the topic of direct variation still continues, and we are going to solve some of the important examples, okay dear student. So before we start, the title of the chapter, as you all know, what is the title is about? It is Ratio and Proportion, okay. That's the title of the chapter, and I already given you idea in my first lecture, dear student, that we are going to study various titles, various topic under this particular title, Ratio and Proportion. We are going to solve many examples based on various topics, okay, Ratio and Proportion, okay. In our previous lecture we have already solved 2 examples based on direct variation, okay. Now dear student, let me write one example here, understand, because I want to take some of the examples from your textbook also. What is given, please note down. I have written number 3 here, not 1, because it's the continuation of the topic of lecture number 1, where we have already solved 2 examples based on direct variation. I am writing it here, X varies, okay. X varies directly as Y. X varies directly as Y, and then written, fill in the blanks, okay. Fill in the blanks. X varies directly as y and fill in the blanks. They have given one box. I'm just drawing the box here. Okay, they have given one box format. Okay. And in box they are showing this way. Somewhat like this they are showing there. Okay. Here they are showing variable x, and here they have shown variable y. Okay. Here they have written 9. Okay. Right. And here 36. And then here they have written 72, and here is fill in the blanks. Okay. You can understand, dear student, what we used to write in terms of verbal format they have given in table, ultimately to looking the same example. See, x varies directly as y. That will comfort you to write the statement of relation between x and y. And dear student, mind this. This gives you the comfort of finding constant k. It can be if y equals to 36, and then dear student, this one is the third data of the sum. Y 72, x equal to question mark. You understood? This is the way the box format can be read and can be understood. Okay? Is it clear in your mind? Let us solve the example. Step remains as usual, as you know. First step, now we'll continue this way. The first, x varies directly as y. Therefore, x equal to ky, where I should have to write compulsorily k not equal to 0. This is compulsory, dear student, to write k not equals to 0. Okay. Second part of the sum, just leave one line and write when x equal to what is given 9, y equals to 36. Okay, write this relation again. X equal to ky, is it clear? Place the value of variable x, that is 9, k constant we are looking for, y 36, transfer it here, 9 upon 36 equals to k. Just cancel it out. K equals to 1 upon 4. First part, the relation. Second part, just taking the value of x and y and finding the constant. Now reading the box format and making the verbal formation, y is 72, you have to find x. So you will write this way: if y equal to 72, x equal to question mark. Okay, y equal to 72, x equal to question mark. Again, please write it down. X equal to ky. X, so you are looking for, what is k? 1 upon 4. What is y? 72. Just cancel it out. So you got x equal to 18. Okay, look at the sum, dear student. Please verify so you will understand it. Actually the data is given in box format, nothing more. Understand? Okay. First you look at the sum. Right. Such examples are also given in textbook where only the statement for the relation is given. One pair of the variable are indirectly given in box format, which will facilitate you to find value of the constant, and the third format where value of one variable is given and another you will find. Okay, so first just have a look at the sum before we move for another example. Okay, first you look at this. Then I would like to give some more example. Okay. Is it clear? Let us go for few more examples. Okay. We are going for example number 4 now. Okay. Note down. See, dear student, what we are going to do is that one example we are solving it here. Understood? Right? And one similar example, okay, I will just give you to solve as we sometime do, and most probably we have done so far in our revision lecture that you all know. Okay, so that way we are going to concentrate here. See the sum. I am writing it. This is the example. Please note down. one dozen of bananas, okay, one dozen of bananas cost rupees 60. Just concentrate. One dozen of banana costs rupees 60. Now the next statement, how many? Just concentrate on the question, how many bananas can be purchased? Can be purchased in rupees 240. Okay, dear student, before I start solving the exam, what is my personal suggestion is, first you read the sum like all those previous example we solve, example number 1, 2 and 3, where you are given the statement directly, that there you must have encountered the statement X varies directly as Y. In every example, you see the first one, the second one and the third, all three examples, one statement was common there. Understood? So here, dear student, you need to be very, very conscious, know where it has been given, that X and Y, but any example cannot be started before supposing both the variables, one variable as X and one variable as Y. Which you will call X and which you will call Y. Some of the students who are not just trying to understand and analyze the sum will directly from the first statement will go, can number of dozen be X and cost of banana be Y? But that is not to be taken, because what you are looking for the second statement, how many bananas, means number of bananas. Understand? So dear student, in solving such type of example, your first target is to catch rightly two physical quantities which you are going to target. Okay, so which physical quantity we are targeting doesn't mean ultimately the number of bananas only. So dear student, solving such example, your first step, let number of bananas be X and total cost be Y rupees. Dear student, this will be your first statement. in solving any such example. This is the first statement, that is the statement of supposing two variables. One has to be taken as x, one has to be taken as y. X means number of bananas we have taken, y means total cost we have taken in rupees. Is there anywhere mentioned that it is a sum of direct variation? But practically, my dear student, you can understand. When you go in market to purchase, here the fruit, banana, any fruit, obviously, more number of fruits you buy, you will pay for more rupees. Is it like that, that you buy more bananas and you pay less rupees? This is not going to happen. So even from the data mentioned in the example, it is you, dear student, who have to decide whether it is an example of direct variation or inverse. That we'll study later. Okay, so now this is the first statement. Okay, now let me write second statement. Okay, 1 dozen bananas cost rupees 60. So what I am writing? Number of bananas I have supposed as x. So dear student, can you understand this or not? I have written, if x equal to 12, you know 1 dozen banana means number of pieces 12. If x equal to 12, then y equals to 60. Okay, first dear student, first you need to write that symbolic statement. Okay, x varies directly as y, x equal to where k not equals to 0. Okay, now the third statement, x equal to 12, y 1 dozen, then y equal to 60. Please concentrate. What I have written, x equal to 12, y equal to 60. Why I have written 12? 1 dozen, you all know and you have knowledge that 1 dozen means 12 pieces, that you know. Let me write this, x equal to ky, x that is 12, k we are looking for, y that is 60. Let us continue here, 60 to be transferred here. Therefore, 12 upon 60 equals to k. Cancel it. So you got k equals to 1 upon 5. Okay. Now, dear student, what is written? How many bananas can be purchased in rupees 240? So, what you will write if y equals to 240, x obviously equal to question mark, because the cost is given and you are looking for how many bananas can be purchased in 240 rupees. Let us write original equation again. X equal to ky. X you are looking for, k you know, 1 upon 5. Y you know, 240, just cancel. Understand, 5 4 ja 8 5 8 ja, what is your answer? 48. Understand? Okay, once you get this answer, you will write at the end your statement. What is that? You will write this way: 48 bananas can be. You have to write this way: can be purchased in rupees 240. Okay. Just look at the sum, dear student, and then I will bifurcate into various steps for you. First, you just have a look at this. Before I give you one example of such type, as a self-study, first you need to understand this. 1 dozen of banana cost rupees 60, and how many can be purchased in rupees 240? You have to find first two physical quantities which you want to relate. So you need to read, my dear student, the whole example. If here it would be had been written how many dozen, so we have taken x as number of dozen, but here they have given how many number of bananas. That means we have to move that way. Some student wants to do this way also. They will take number of take an example, number of dozen as x, so ultimately they will get answer in dozen. They have to multiply by 12. That way also you can solve. Okay, first you look at the sum. See, dear student, first part of the sum, second part of the sum, finding the relation, showing them in symbolic format, removing the variation sign and presenting as x equal to ky. This is the third step, where two values of two related variable will comfort you to find the value of the constant. And the fourth step, where after finding constant, you will be given value of one variable and rest of the variable you will find. Okay, first you just have a look at the example we have solved here, and then one more example of the same type, dear student, as an SLP, which we seldom sometime give you during even lecture also. Okay, is it clear in your mind? Okay, have you written it? Let me give you one more example of same type. Okay, and you will try to solve it. first you write it, dear student, because sometime it happens that when we are explaining the sum, your attention might remain on the explanation and you may not be able to write sometime. So after explaining and writing the sum, I just pause for 1 minute so that you can write whatever is left, okay? And so that you can follow in the next example in SLP, okay? Okay, let me write one example and you will solve the way I have solved it here, okay? Let us write the example. You will solve the example systematically in SLP, okay? Let me write example number 5. If the, write down with me, if the cost of if the cost of one score oranges is rupees, if the cost of one score oranges is rupees 45, okay, then this is the question. Then how many oranges can be purchased? Purchased, okay, in rupees 144, okay. First you read the data, dear student, try to understand, okay, and solve it by yourself. First you need to look at the previous example which we have solved. Based on the previous example, just conceptualize the whole example in your mind and then try to solve it. What has been given here that you need to understand, if the cost of one score oranges is rupees 45, then how many oranges can be purchased in rupees 144? First you read at the given data and try to solve it. Just have a look at the given data. Just 2 to 3 minutes time, dear student, and then I will solve it here. Just 2 minutes now. You need to suppose two variables. That's very important. One of the variable means one of the physical quantity will be labeled as variable X, and another will be labeled as variable Y. So your first duty is to ascertain about that. Then you will go for the second step in just representing the data in format of X and Y. Then you will find constant K. Then you will find one of the unknown variable value. Okay, this is the way you need to solve this example. Just 1 minute, dear student, and then I will solve it, and you need to just verify. Okay, just have a look at the sum. SLP are also sometime delivered to you. The purpose is the instantaneous realization of the concept which you have studied. Understood? Once you do any example and when the concept becomes clear in your mind, and that is an instant realization of that. That is what our target always remains. Okay? Just concentrate. We are starting solving this example in a short time. Okay. From the first statement, you need to understand which two physical quantities are in relation. Here, number of oranges, one score you all know, 20. Understand? So, dear student, you must have solved by yourself also. I am just showing it here, okay? Let X be number of oranges. Okay, let X be number of oranges and cost of oranges be Y rupees. First statement. Let X be number of oranges and cost of oranges be Y. Then let us write in symbolic presentation. X varies to Y. Therefore, एक्स इक्वल टू के वाई, के नॉट इक्वल्स टू जीरो. नाउ व्हाट इज द कॉस्ट ऑफ वन स्क्वायर ऑरेंज? रुपीज 45. सो द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द सम यू विल राइट. वन स्क्वायर, डियर स्टूडेंट, यू ऑल मस्ट बी नोइंग. x equal to 20, then y equals to 45. Rupees I am not mentioning just now. Write the relation again. X equal to ky, 20 equal to k into 45. Is it clear? X equal to 20 we got from here. If the cost of one square, and you dear student know one square means 40, you know. Okay, just a minute. So I have to write here 40, right? Sorry. Okay, clear? From here also you will get 1 square 20, you will write x equal to 20, y equal to 45. Again the main relation, x equal to ky, you will place the value of x and y to find k, and for that transfer it here. We are carrying the sum here, therefore 20 upon 45 equals to k. Let us cancel. Okay, for just you can cancel by 4 ja 5, 9 ja, you got k equals to 4 upon 9. What is the last question? How many oranges can be purchased in rupees? 144. So you will write this way. If y equals to 144, x obviously equal to question mark. Again, write the relation. X equal to ky, x you are looking for. What is k? 4 upon 9. What is the value of y here? 144 just cancel. 9, 16 ja. 16, 4 ja. 64. That means in rupees 144, you are able to buy how many oranges? 64. So at last, what you will write? 64. This is compulsory, dear. 64 oranges can be purchased in rupees 144. You need to write the final statement. Okay, you see the sum. The first part, supposing both the variable as x and y. Second part, representation in term of x and y. Third part, utilizing the values of two related variable and finding k. And the fourth part, utilizing the value of k and finding another variable when the value of one variable has already been given. You understood this? So dear student, these are still want to solve few more examples. Understand? in next lecture, but before we end today's lecture number 2, what is important for you is to conceptualize in your mind the concept of direct variation, because we may are also going to solve some difficult examples also based on direct variation. But mind one more thing, in exam nobody is going to tell you that it is an example of direct variation or not. It is you yourself that you have to guess from the given data either it is of direct variation or inverse variation. Okay, dear student, so we expect you must be paying attention, understand the concept very clearly. Okay, thank you very much.